Thank you so very much. You're welcome to this episode 2 of season 4, Broken But Not Destroyed. I believe that the Lord has been blessing you on this platform. Please take your time to make sure you have gone through the previous episodes and seasons so that the Lord can continue blessing and ministering to you. My name is Apostle Paul from Turning Point Church in Nakuru, Kenya, and it's always a blessing to come and minister to you wherever you are. I appreciate your remarks. I appreciate your sharing this message to as many people as possible. In this episode 2, I want to speak with us about brokenhearted by grief. Brokenhearted by grief. Many people are grieving. A lot of things have happened. You have lost a loved one. You have lost a husband, a mother, a daddy, a sister, a child. And this is very hurtful. At times, it's not even somebody that you are related to, but somebody that really mattered, somebody that really did something that has made you who you are, the only to be told that that person has passed on. And the pain is just too much. It's so real, and like it has refused to leave. No matter the comfort of friends, relatives, you are still grieving, and you are wondering whether you'll be able to move on. You're wondering whether you can be able to summon any strength to be able to adjust, to accept, and be able to move on. The truth of the matter, grief is a very, very painful emotion. It blinds from reality. It fuels helplessness, and you cannot just continue like that. One thing I know as a man of God, it is okay to grieve, but it is wrong to prolong grief. And that's why I want to help you, because if you continue grieving for a long while, the results are going to be regrettable. And therefore, I want to invite you to this message. God is going to bless you in Jesus' wonderful name. You know, scripture says that death is an enemy. There is no death that comes to make you happy. Every death that takes place, it leaves people who are hurting. It leaves families that some families disintegrate. At times, death even fuels conflict. At times, death opens a door for poverty to follow, or even some people to drop out of school. Some deaths can even make somebody to lose their properties and so forth. And therefore, grief is not just because somebody has died, but the effect of the death of that person. And that's why it's good that you get to understand that death is an enemy. He comes to hurt. Death comes to hurt. Well, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 26 says, the last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. So just know that death is an enemy, and therefore approach it as such. Approach it as such. When you know he's an enemy, you now make sure you do not give death the pleasure to ruin more than he has already ruined. He has taken somebody that you care, somebody who has been a blessing to you, somebody that you wanted at least to one day be able to appreciate in kind or whichever way, but now you have no opportunity. I want you to know that this is very normal, but my prayer for you is that you will not overgrieve. You will not take your grief to levels that are going to ruin your great destiny. Remember, you are alive. Now, there are several facts that you should have to help you come out of grief. And those are the points I want to give you. Number one, that is very crucial, know that death is not the end. Just know the loss of your loved one, the loss of that person that was so instrumental in making who you are today, is not the end. Death is not the end. It is always a beginning of eternity. Death is the gateway to another life. And that's why scripture uses the word sleep. The person that died slept, and especially if that person was born again, you know that that person is in heaven, and you will one day, if you're born again, you'll be able to meet that person someday. That should be able to give you the consolation. Death is not the end. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verses 13 and 14, the Bible says, but I wish I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no home. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. So the word of God is saying that there are two levels of grieving. The grieving of people who don't believe in Jesus is different because they have no hope. But if you are born again, if Jesus is Lord in your life, your grieving is totally different, because we grieve yet we have hope. We know that we will someday meet, because that person did not vanish, never to be seen again. We will meet again. And that is, the Bible says that we should console each other with these words. And I'm consoling you today to let you know that you lost your father, that you lost your wife, that you lost your child. It's not the end. You will meet if you continue holding on to the faith. Number two crucial fact that you need to remember so as to come out of grief is that you have a life to live. Don't let the dead ruin your life. You have a life to live. Don't let the dead ruin your life. You see, the truth of the matter, as some of us, we are so close to some people we have grown to love and care for, and we want to live forever. Though we all know that we will someday die, we never want to think about dying. And death comes, and then it plucks one of us. It feels so cruel, so unfair, and so bad. And then there are things that you had planned, there are things that you wanted to do, and you feel so bad, and you wish if only that person can come back and you can be able to follow through the plans that you had. But the reality of the matter is that dead has finished their course. Now, if you are alive, wherever you are, just know you have a life. That you are alive is a message that God is not done with you, that there is something that God is expecting from you. So do not allow the dead to continue interfering and ruining your life because they died. You know, by the way, you need to understand, if the people who are dead are asked what they would advise you today, you'll be surprised what they will say. For example, in the book of Luke chapter 16, verse 27 and 28, there was this rich man. He died, and when he was in hell, he saw Father Abraham and Lazarus, and he started talking to them, and he requested Father Abraham to send somebody from the grave to go talk to his family. You see, the person that you died, that you cared for, if he was to be asked what you should be doing right now, they will be speaking some very, very positive things the way I am talking to you. For example, this one, the Bible says, then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house, for I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. So you see, he was sending a message that I have my family there, I care for them, they cared for me, but I know that the way they were living is wrong. And now that I've already died, I would like them not to follow me. I would like them to live a better life. That was the advice this rich dead man was saying. Brethren, I want you to know, please don't let the dead to ruin your life. Continue believing, continue living your life, continue pursuing what you can do. Don't continue mourning, don't continue wearing mourning garments. Please take a shower, go out, take yourself out, begin to replan your plans for the future, and God is going to help you. I know it is not easy, but if you believe this word of God, it is going to be possible. The Holy Spirit is the major comforter. He'll be able to comfort you, and you will be able to move on. But you have to be willing to leave grief behind. Number three fact that is very, very important You are alive for a reason. Just know that you didn't die, that you are not the one that died. You are the one that was left living. There is a reason. So begin to look for the reason. Why are you alive? Why didn't you die in that road accident? Why were you not poisoned? Why have you survived so many near-death matters? You have always kind of escaped. There is a reason. You better know there is something special about you. You have an assignment that you need to fulfill, and you cannot give up. So I challenge you, just get to know there is a reason why you are alive. And believe you me, that reason is not the reason to continue grieving. No, no, no. You have a better thing. There is something special. Just discover it. I'll pray for you, and God is going to help you. Number four. Fact that you need to know so that you can come out of grief is that know that prolonged grief is a hindrance to what God wants to do. Prolonged grief hinders God's intention for you. For example, in the book of Luke chapter 7 from verse 11 all the way to verses 13 there, you will meet a woman. This woman was really hurting. She had just buried her husband, and within a short while, the son died. So you can imagine going to the cemetery twice within a short span. It was so painful. All the village had gathered to comfort this woman, and no amount of words of comfort and gifts could relieve her of the loss, of the pain, of the grief, until verse 13, when Jesus came as they were going to bury the boy. The Bible says, verse 13, and when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said unto her, weep not, weep not. Someone out there is listening to me. You've been weeping continually. You have not been able to wipe away the tears of the loss of a loved one. That person was too close to you, too special to you, and you can't just believe that that person is fully dead. You have lost your strength. You have lost your vision. You have no vigor. You don't want to meet anyone else. You are wondering whether to die. You're even contemplating dying to join the person. Please just know that that prolonged grief will hinder what God wants for you. There is more for you than you can know right now. But Jesus told this woman, do not weep, because as long as you are weeping, there is something God cannot do. Jesus knew he had the power to change the life of the woman, but he could not release that power while she was weeping. So he told this woman, weep not. And I'm telling somebody, do not weep. Let the Lord have his way. You shall be surprised what will become of you. In 1 Samuel chapter 16 and verses 1, the Bible speaks about prophet Samuel and says, and the Lord said unto Samuel, how long wilt thou mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Fill thine horn with oil and go. I will send thee to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided me a king among his sons. So you see, God is also rebuking prophet Samuel for prolonged grief. He was mourning that God had rejected the man that he anointed and announced in the nation as the king, and he was in great mourning. And God does not rebuke the grief, but rebukes the time. He says, how long? How long? So it's okay to grieve, but not too long, because if you take too long, you begin hindering what God wants to do for you. And number five, an ending grief can lead to death. Just know, as you continue grieving for a long time, that grief, it is going to finally take you to the grave. Believe you me, I remember some years ago, we buried the son of my neighbor where I was staying, and he was an only son. The mother was very hurt. The mother especially, she cried very, very much. They had only one son. And when we buried that son, he died at around age 40. The son had not married, and therefore no grandson. So after 7 days from the day of the funeral, the mother was grieving, was still grieving and wondering, how can she continue without a son, without anyone else other than the old husband? And this woman took off from the house and went to the cemetery, and she sat next to the grave of the son. And I don't know what she was talking to the grave, and within no time she died right there. I remember we were told that she just died by the grave, and we started the process of going to bury her again. Grief does not end in the right place. If you continue keeping it, it will lead you in a place that you're going to regret. So please brace yourself, strengthen yourself in the Lord, and let the time that you have grieved, let it be enough. Put a full stop, please. Put a full stop to that grief that you have been grieving, and now stand up again. You have a life to live. Begin to pursue your fresh dreams in Jesus' mighty name. God is going to help you. In Genesis 37, verses 34 to 35, Jacob was also in a similar condition. He had loved his son Joseph above every other of the sons. And the word of God says that because of that favoritism, the brothers, they hated Joseph until they sold him to Egypt, and they brought the coat that Joseph was wearing. They showed the coat to his father, to their father, and the father knew, recognized the dress as belonging to his son. And in verse 34, 35, the Bible says, "And Jacob rent his clothes and put sackcloth upon his loins, and mourned for his son many days. And all his sons and all his daughters rose up to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted, and he said, 'For I will go down into the grave unto my son mourning.' Thus his father wept for him." Notice that he took so long. It was an unending grief. He did not want to let go his son. He did not want to believe. And he even said that he will go down to the grave because of mourning his son. So please, that mourning, that continued grief, it will not let you go in the right direction. It will take you to the grave. If you don't want to go to the grave, please stop that grieving. Remember, even if you are to die, some people will grieve, but they will not remain there. They will bury you and they'll continue with their own life. So please put it to an end. And finally, number 6, grief drains strength. Grief eliminates your vigor. It drains you of stamina. And that is why you must not continue grieving. Leave the cemetery, leave that coffin. Make sure you can be able to rise up again. It's okay to mourn. Even Jesus wept. We all know that he wept during that time that around the grave of Lazarus, but he did not remain there. He did not continue weeping for long. Within a short while, he was himself. And that is why I'm saying it's okay to grieve, but make sure it does not take forever. Come out of it so that it does not continue draining you of strength. Strength to fight, strength to believe again, strength to pursue. You need to make sure you protect yourself. Scripture says in Proverbs 17, verse 22, "A merry heart doeth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit dries the bones." Grief dries the bones. That sorrow, it will dry the energy. It will remove the strength. The word of God says the joy of the Lord is our strength. You need that strength. You are going through a lot of things. You have so many unfinished matters. You need to be strong. Therefore, make sure you do away with grief. Let it come to an end so that you can be able to be strong enough to pursue what you need to do. Other people are dependent on you. So your children, they are looking upon you for strength. You have a vision. Begin to think how you can make it happen. So don't let grief to continue holding you down in the name of Jesus Christ. That is why If you are not born again, you must be born again so that the Holy Spirit can help you, because some of the pains that are brought about by loss of a loved one, they are too much. There are no human words that can be able to eliminate the pain. But the Holy Ghost, He has a way to get to the very bottom of your pain, and He can embrace you and help you and guide you and even strengthen you. He is the greatest comforter. And that is why today I challenge you, if you're not born again, make sure you receive Jesus in your life. And you do that by a simple prayer. If you can follow after these words, you can receive Jesus right now. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me my sins. Write my name in the book of life. I receive Christ in me. Holy Spirit, take over in Jesus' mighty name. If you have prayed that prayer, Jesus has come into your life. He shall be your continuous help. The Holy Ghost shall give you all the comfort that you need. I want to pray for every one of you that is grieving out there, that the hand of God is going to help you to overcome the after effects of the loss of a loved one. Heavenly Father, I pray that your strength is going to be injected upon everybody who has lost a valuable person. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. You knew that it would happen, but I also know that you planned how they are going to navigate their life out of that pain. Send that help right now, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let the comfort of the Holy Ghost finally bring that grief to an end in Jesus' name. Father, oh, make their vision clearer than death in Jesus' name, and let them get the strength to rise up and to pursue their vision again in Jesus' wonderful name. God bless you. I believe that what has blessed you, you have been helped. You can now rise up. You will not be destroyed. You have listened to this wisdom. May God bless you. Make sure you subscribe. Hit on the notification bell so that when we upload another video, you shall be the very first one to enjoy the benefits of listening to Apostle Paul from Turning Point, Nakuru. God bless you so much. This is episode 2. Follow episode 3 shortly.